welcome to the Texas Hemp Show. This is podcast number 70, actually. Podcast number 70. I'm Russell Dowden, publisher for the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine. And we are just released our 10th issue of the magazine's out in newsstands around Houston and Austin, Texas. They're also available all throughout the state with all of the licensed hemp farmers growing hemp around the lovely Long Star State. And so podcast number 70 here of the Texas Hemp Show. Check out our website, TexasHempReporter.com. And the reason I say to go and check out the website today is because our guest joining us is Mike Biegalski from the Flex Payment Solutions. And their article from the magazine made the digital version this week on TexasHempReporter.com. So if you want to check out the website as we hear this week's podcast, number 70, you'll get to chime in and hear our guest and then maybe read the article as well, as it has just recently been posted finally here this month on the website. So welcome. Let me bring on the mic here for Mike with us. So welcome to the Texas Hemp Show. Mike, how are you, my friend?
Russ, I am great. I appreciate you having me, and congratulations to start here, putting you through the ringer with the last name, and you did a great job.
Hey, that, I meant to ask you off air, actually, that I had it right, and I kind of was slow about getting that, saying that right, but thanks for recognizing that. I know your brother. I've ran into him at several of the Lucky Leaf Expos. I believe we ran into them in Houston or Austin and then Dallas. You guys have had those booths at the Lucky Leaf with Chad. And so we've been running into you guys since last year. I guess, was it Mo that was with him in those booths in Texas? Your Chicago rep.
Probably. Yeah, probably Dom on.
Oh, Dom.
So, yeah,
yes,
close enough on the name.
Yes, it was Dom. And Dom had a birthday I saw on LinkedIn there the other day. So.
Absolutely, yes. Happy late birthday to Dom. And yeah, my brother Matt and Dom, since we brought him on later last year, have been making the rounds to the CBD shows. We hit Texas pretty hard, partially because Matt lives down in Houston by you guys, and then partially we're a participant with the Texas Hemp Coalition, so our home office isn't there, but as I just mentioned, we have a presence in the state. So we have been around quite a bit, and we have been meeting a lot of folks. So hopefully some of the listeners here have run across us in person as well.
Well, you guys have, and you've had a good network down here. You've had a good presence. We were aware of you guys, and we kind of started a dialogue with your brother. And then, you know, we kind of brought you guys onboarded you as an advertiser with the magazine. And we've just kind of developed this relationship with you guys in the last 6 months. And I've learned about this service for folks. Again, Flex Payment Solutions. Flex offers you the rapid, ever-changing world of payment processing. You guys have all experienced this, whether you're in CBD or Delta 8 or retail or even just a farmer. We experienced many challenges when we started the Texas Hemp Reporter initially with Square, and that did not go well. We ended up having been with them for 11 years. Square kicked us off their platform after just a month or so of doing the Texas Hemp Reporter. And we don't even touch cannabis nor hemp. We just report on it. But Mike, just tell us a little bit about the business and how you got started and just give us an initial rundown on Flex Payment Solutions.
Absolutely. So no, you're correct. Yes, we are on the payment side of things. So we're a third-party sender, a direct ISO. We work directly with a handful of banks, and it's really to help businesses in general move money, collect money. We work with some business types, not necessarily in this space, that push money out to consumers and businesses as opposed to collecting payments. So very multifaceted. Our start was, it's a family-owned company, and the oldest brother in the family is who I work with. That's our president, Rob.
Okay.
And their family's historically in like small dollar lending, like business loans, online loans, that kind of stuff, which is hard to get payments for as well. So our business was kind of born out of necessity. There was a home office group and a big number of mutual contacts that were always in need of payment partners. So that was our start. And we've gotten very good at working with businesses that need a little bit more understanding, that need a little bit more, I don't want to say handholding, but massaging through the banking process so the banks understand everything that's going on. Here's how the businesses are safe to board. Here's how we're going to monitor them from an ongoing standpoint. And that's kind of where we are today. The hemp space seemed really ripe for our services, specifically because of the story you just told. There's a lot of groups that have lost processing services through, let's say, a Square, mm-hmm. just because hemp's in the name. Like you guys, you don't touch product. It was literally a word in your name.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I've been a magazine publisher for 20 years, and I had a Texas Sports Monthly, my sports magazine. We had been using the Square services since 2011. So when we first started the Hemp Reporter in the spring of 2020, over 2 years ago now, coming up as, we were able to do it. But I mean, I don't know, Mike, I think I did some business with a seed company in Colorado or something, and it red flagged it because I didn't really have that merchant account set up under the Hemp Reporter initially. But we certainly started doing business with people from Oregon, California, Colorado, and I think some of the clients that we were bringing on in the magazine were of that high-risk nature, and Square caught wind of that and froze the account.
Yep, and it happens all the time, and it's such a shame because, you know, high-risk, I think, is the general public term, but we always like to say, especially industries like CBD and hemp, it's managed risk. Mm-hmm. There's definitely opportunities for bad players to come in, you know, sell hot product. I mean, you're essentially putting people's health at risk with some of the bad ends of this stuff. So mm-hmm. there's reasons to be tentative, to take your time reviewing things. But there's a lot of great people in this space. There's a lot of great products that help people in this space. So it's not, of our opinion, something that needs to be thrown to the side. It's a different approach than traditional processing. And I think a lot of the groups that have started to work with us, you included, you just went through the application process pretty recently.
Yeah, today.
I think they've grown, exactly. Yeah. And I think they've grown to understand, you know, it may take a couple extra questions, a couple extra signatures on docs, but when it's all said and done, you know, you're getting a normal traditional processing account and you're working with a group like Flax and a bank that understands the industry you're in. So it's not like it's going away, you know, because the wind changes in the next couple of weeks.
Well, and what's cool is that I've gotten to know you guys. You've been an advertiser. We've been doing business, and little by little, Matt, your brother, has been bringing me on and educating me on the platform. And I started to do this initially as orders for magazines. We have a WooCommerce set up on the back end that we just added this in December for Texas Hemp Reporter. This is so listeners can purchase merchandise or purchase a magazine ad or a subscription perhaps. But as I got to talking with Matt, I explained that, you know, really the bulk of my business is the invoicing side. And that was where I felt like I need to do that and implement the WooCommerce shopping cart, the online store as well. So you guys are helping me with both aspects of my business.
For sure. And that's a great example. And I think it's part of the reason why we retain clients for a long time and we develop like deep relationships, like we've already got started on your end. Because we run all of our own systems, so everything's super customizable. If you need a specific invoice message like you have, mm-hmm. it's easy for us to program that into the system. Mm-hmm. If you need fraud protection on a subscription service, there's a lot of those in the space. Mm. It's easy to kind of layer that stuff in if it doesn't exist yet. So, yeah, it really works out well, I think, just us being a more boutique shop, kind of a people-first shop, and the specific needs of the space. Yeah, I think everyone's had a good show so far. And it's fun to do that stuff, honestly, to get into the customized projects.
It really is. Our guest, Mike Biegalski with Flex Payment Solutions, joining us here on podcast number 70 of the Texas Hemp Show. Mike, why is it so hard for businesses like mine and other CBD or Delta 8 merchants to keep a good merchant account? Is it the regulatory side of things with banking and the financial institutions? I tried to get on with Frost, my bank here in Texas, and they had me sign up with their service, which was Clover. and Clover denied me as well. So I kind of got stuck, as you know, and have seen doing business with me. I'm kind of stuck with one of those larger international ones, and I'm looking to leave them and of course on board with you guys. But is it the regulations with the banks? What is it we're dealing with here that is making it so hard for everyone to get a processor?
I think part of it is there's a long history behind this stuff, obviously, and it tracks very similarly up until recent history, like cannabis did. Mm-hmm. So anything that isn't very clearly spelled out by the government, hey, this is okay, you're allowed to sell, produce, consume, whatever it is, this product, banks aren't going to touch it. They're very conservative. When they get into hot water with the government and with their regulators, things go south very quickly. So because of that, they're historically slow to move, slow to do new things, you know, slow to jump into any kind of publicly seen gray area. So I think that's a big part of it, despite the farm bill being, you know, out, enacted for a very long time, obviously hasn't been dinged up too much since it was introduced as far as changes. Even with that being out, there's some banks that are still going to be scared of it just because the people managing it in their lifetime, these products weren't legal. And sometimes those ideas just don't go away. And I think the other end of it is it does take, as I mentioned, a little extra work, definitely a lot more ongoing compliance than a lot of industry types to make sure that groups you're boarding in this space are keeping everything, you know, on the rails, keeping the bank safe as far as the bank's fraud concerns are, you know, about. And I think there's just some banks that don't have the infrastructure or the desire or both to manage all of that. So I think a lot of the time what you find now is there is smaller banks that are willing to make that effort, and they maybe don't always have the technology to create the full stack that you guys as a merchant need. So that's where groups like Flex try to come in and bridge the gap for everybody.
Well, it's really cool, and I'm excited to try this service. A, as a business owner that does B2B business with business owners like you guys, I much rather support a local or regional business than some gigantic corporate conglomerate, you know, that you can't even get anyone on the phone for customer service with. So I'm real excited to try this product with you guys. Who are you bringing on? We mentioned earlier off air that you guys are part of the Texas Hemp Coalition. Alyssa Nolan does write with us. I know a lot of the guys like Jeremy and Jesse with New Bloom Labs. What's that relationship like with you guys? Are you finding that, are they using you with the coalition? Are you picking up clients from that network?
Absolutely. So we process for the coalition's website and for membership and all that kind of stuff. So anybody who signed up or bought anything, we appreciate it. And then, yes, a bunch of the groups under there, we've either got them started. Jeremy's groups are a good example. I think two of his, at least, DBAs are on with us right now. And then a number of the other groups we're getting everything set up with pretty much in the last few weeks. A lot of them have jumped on. There have been some issues, concerns, whatever you want to put it as, with some Square stuff. So I think where we've been sitting in the background for some of those folks for the last couple months, because we haven't been members for that long.
Yeah.
But sitting as kind of a redundancy option for the last few months, we're pushing the pedal down a little bit more and getting some of that stuff live just because of some concerns that have come up. So actually, it's a really, timing's good to ask that question, because we've gotten a little more busy with that whole group really recently.
Well, get online, folks. If you're listening here to the show, check out flexpaymentsolutions.com. Get a free quote. Check out their services for your business. They are the first. They were the first service that we actually talked to about getting onboarded with this that didn't turn us down. So, you know, these guys, their doors are open, and we're excited to let them handle our invoicing as well as our online processing for orders. And we're excited about working with this. I saw something on the website earlier today. Where was it? Payments by voice or text? Tell us about this feature.
Absolutely. It's a great question. So we do an IVR, which is like an automated phone line, and a text messaging service that can do a couple of different things. One of which, Russ, the invoice that you just mentioned, we can send that out via text, and you can have an option, either click on this link to pay, or if it's a card that we've already seen, you can make it as easy as, you know, reply yes to make your payment, and we'll go get the card that's already tokenized and securely saved on file, and we'll go run the payment off of that. So it creates a lot of flexibility, again, in subscription and recurring payment kind of programs. If you've got a service where it's splitting the payments up into four, that's gotten so darn popular. Something like that. It could make the communication a little easier, because we've pretty consistently seen when some of those programs have some issues with, like, chargebacks, people complaining, hey, why did you hit my card? I didn't give you permission, kind of thing. Yeah. A lot of the times it's just because there hasn't been communication in a while between the CBD company that they've got on a subscription deal and the consumer. So even just a little text message reminder, hey, you know, your payment's coming out in the next 3 days.
Yeah, it
can be helpful sometimes. Well, and that's what that service does.
That's really cool. I noticed that I get that with other things, like going to my dentist or making a payment with my insurance agent. These text by voice or payments with text reminders, that's a very convenient feature. One of the things I mentioned to Matt about earlier today, when I was onboarding with my application, there was a feature in the application that asked for instant deposit or instant direct, and it was just one of the features that you can get. I was getting signed up for invoicing and online, but I had mistook that feature for an instant deposit, and he said you know, because some of these national ones I can pay an extra 1 or 2% to get the convenience of having that deposit instantly. I know, how does your deposits work, and is that instant option of something that's going to be coming down the road, or do y'all have that? How can you talk about how the payments are processed?
Yes. So, and actually, the feature that you saw will eventually introduce the instant option. So right now we can do either next day or second day deposit. So that's money into your bank account after, you know, we've processed the payments and everything. But what you saw was that InstaPay program. We use that now, and I mentioned this earlier, for customers of ours that need a business that needs to send money to another business or a consumer. And what they can do with that program is use a debit card on the other end and push money from an account at our bank to that debit card in about 10 to 30 seconds. It moves very, very quickly. So you're already getting there in your head. What we're going to do is program our back end to, once we see Mike paid Russ $100. Again, it'll take a little programming work, but as soon as the system sees that, we'll have a slush account, fire $100 to Texas Hemp Reporter's debit card, and then bam, you guys have your money to go right away.
Nice. Yeah, that's been something that the other ones have been doing for some years now, and I had that with that option, and I got so spoiled doing that option, honestly, Mike, that I think you're good. By not having it, you're going to save me 2% just coming on board with Flex.
Well, and you know what, that is why it's a great point, though, why we want to develop that, is not charging 2%, but you saw enough value in it to pay that at one point, so why don't we bring it maybe for a couple bucks, and then everyone ends up getting a W out of it.
Yeah, because I think it's good business for you guys as well. Flex payment solutions, flexible options, custom solutions as well. CBD payment processing made easy. I am looking at their ad in the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine. Guys, if you've got a copy of the magazine, turn to page 11 in the magazine. Get to see what their ad copy looks like, you know, in the magazine. I think it's a good thing to check that out and take a good look at it. Visit flexpaymentsolutions.com for a little bit of onboarding information. This is fast, convenient processing, and it's good stuff. We're excited to be talking. Podcast number 70. We'll be back with Flex Payment Solutions. This is Mike Biegalski with us here, joining us on podcast number 70 of the Texas Hemp Show. We'll be back right after this, guys.
Hey, this is Cheech Marin, and you're listening to the Texas Hemp Show.
Why take a chance with your hemp grow? Join Hemp Plan and avoid the risk. TPS Labs' exclusive hemp monitoring program. Hemp Plan members get one-on-one consulting from knowledgeable consultants who are available when you need them most. If you want to take the guesswork out of growing hemp and focus on what matters most, call TPS Lab today and ask for your free consultation. Take the next step to a successful harvest. Visit tpslab.com or call today at 956-383-0739.
You're listening to the Texas Hemp Show, sponsored by The Loot. The Loot, helping vape and smoke shops deliver the most innovative products to customers. Constantly creating new products that people love. E-liquid, salts, CBD topicals, tincture flower, edibles, and Delta 8. Your customers will be shouting, "Give me The Loot!" The Loot, creating high-margin products for vape and smoke shop. Contact us today at thelootjuice.com for all your vape, CBD, and Delta 8 needs. Mention Texas Hemp Reporter for 10% off. Give me The Loot!
The Texas Hemp Reporter is available free at all CBD and smoke shops in Houston and Austin, Texas, expanding to Dallas and San Antonio this year. Cannabis is slowly becoming legal in Texas, so be sure to listen to the Texas Hemp Show podcast every week, wherever podcasts are available. The premier hemp and marijuana advocacy publication for Texas, the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine. Mailed to over 2,000 licensed hemp producers in Texas. News, technology, trends, finance, culture, health, all things hemp in the Lone Star State. Now in our third year, with more than 100,000 copies made available free at over 1,000 CBD and smoke shops in Texas. That's the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine and the Texas Hemp Show. Visit online at texashempreporter.com and listen wherever podcasts are available. Now, back to the show with your host, Russell Dowden.
All right, welcome back to the Texas Hemp Show. This is podcast number 70. I'm Russell Dowden, publisher and editor for the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine. And yes, you can check those out all around the state of Texas. We are expanding up into the Dallas area and San Antonio here next month. And I've got some cool things cooking in the fire, if you will, about with regards to the podcast and the radio show. We were on KLBJ here in Austin all fall last year, and so we are going to expand to multiple stations in the Lone Star State. So we are going to be announcing some multiple. There'll be about five stations at least starting out that will have the Texas Hemp Show available later here, coming into later this spring around May. And so we'll talk about that in the coming months. But that is all cooking together, coming together for us in the background there. But podcast number 70, our friends over at Flex Payment Solutions joining us. Mike, welcome back to the show, my friend.
Thank you, sir. No, as I said earlier, appreciate being on here. It's always fun to jump on, just have like a casual conversation about the space and what's going on.
Well, it's an exciting space, the CBD, the hemp, the cannabis. You know, New Mexico's coming on board with full recreational cannabis here in about on the 1st of April. Things are, we've got a new primary coming up here in Texas. The laws are constantly changing, and it's very exciting opportunity. And you guys are nationwide, and you've just been getting and developing into Texas as we've gotten to know you guys recently. Tell us about the background of the company and how long y'all been around.
So we've been around since late 2016, late 2015. 2016, we did a bunch of product development, so it's always been a pretty skinny team. It was just three of us for the first probably 18 to 20 months, mm-hmm. and it was just setting up back office, getting products ready, getting ready to, you know, actually launch the thing, though it existed at the time. And then in 17, we hit the market. We had one product, mainly just cashing checks for people online, just digital checks, and since then, we've grown. We've got about six products, if you include the IBR and tech stuff. You know, we did just under $1 billion in total volume last year. So it's ramped up really quickly. But we've, in my opinion, certainly kept the family-owned company vibe, the people-first approach. So it's been a good mix. I think our customers are getting the same relationship from us, the same interactions with us, but we've got a lot more ammo than we used to, that's for sure.
Well, you also have a good crew. I really enjoyed meeting Dom and Matt at those events, and they're always talking to the folks, introducing the product and the solutions to customers. So you guys have done some good things over there, and it seems like it's an exciting young company.
You're certainly right. We're hiring for a couple more this year. I think we finally hit a phase where there's enough to spread out. There's enough growth that we're trying to accomplish in the CBD hemp market, as well as a couple others, where it is a pretty consistently growing team. And I think, like I just mentioned, everyone on our end has done a really good job of understanding what we do and being able to really efficiently problem solve when our merchants reach out. That's one thing I think I take a lot of pride with our group in, is everything doesn't result in, oh, I'll have to go talk to tech and let you know, or, oh, I'll have to go talk to Mike or Rob and let you know. Our group solves problems, and as you experience through the app process, it saves you a heck of a lot of time.
Well, you know, some of those bigger guys, you can't even get, you have to send an email, provide a
There's
text.
There's not a phone line, right?
Yeah, you can't even get a phone call in. So those guys, we're just, for that alone, it's to be able to just pick up you guys. And no, that, see, now I have your phone number, too. I can actually just call you. Hey, Mike, I need a hand with something.
That's what he does. He traps you. He's not even going to release this podcast. He just got my number myself.
Mike, tell us what businesses are good for this service.
We do, so really, I mean, the easy answer is everybody, but what do I think we do well? I think we do online well. Mm-hmm. We started with a lot of e-commerce. We've got really good internal fraud protections, and I think we've got enough internal data where we spot trends really well. Hey, this may be going south. You may want to tweak this in your settings kind of conversations. So I think that's our bread and butter, but I think more than anything, retail or online, mm-hmm. what we look for is higher risk as far as banks would consider, harder to understand, kind of more detailed industries. And I think our group, despite the size, does a good job of getting in the weeds with merchants, understanding their business and their exact needs, and then relaying to our bank, here's why they're safe to onboard, and here's how we're going to confirm all of that. Because those groups are usually really ignored. The banks don't like to deal with them, and they're still viable businesses. And our opinion is, we're willing to make the effort and take the time to help those groups out if they're just willing to play ball with us on some of the application lengthiness or whatever it is.
Make your business grow with Flex Payment Solutions, flexible options, custom solutions. What does this mean when you say custom reports? I see this on the ad here in the magazine. Can you provide a financial statement for just to see where a business is spending, where they can get an edge? What do the reports offer?
All kinds of things, honestly. We give really good invoicing to help you break down your fee schedule. Where are we spending, the most money card processing? What card brand is it? Mm. Is it debit or credit mm-hmm. cards? Mm-hmm. You can understand all of those kind of metrics for, pricing purposes, for holiday, big sale purposes. What can we expect to jump up here? I think all of that's really useful. And then we also just give very detailed transaction reporting. You guys can jump in, see, any transactions that have settled, any that bounced for any reason. You can pull up historical data by date, month, week. So in addition to your, product management systems, which everyone's going to have, the card reporting is a nice little ancillary check just for sales, for, amounts hitting our bank account. All of that's housed in the same place. So it makes it very easy for your team to learn how to use it and then obviously access it later.
Well, I'm really excited to try this out and see what the features are. There's an article on page 4 in the current edition that's also in there. You have the ad on page 11, but there's a nice little article I wanted to tell listeners and readers of the magazine to check out. Our reporter Stacy reached out to you guys, and it's a really informative article also on page 4 of the current edition of the Texas Hemp Reporter that you guys can read and follow. I want to ask, and we just got a couple more for you here, Mike. One of the things I wanted to do is I told myself in the first couple of years of the Texas Hemp Reporter, we've obviously made the magazines available free to all of the licensed hemp permit holders. The growers get them. The farmers have been getting them. this is getting very expensive. And I knew that eventually, after the first couple of years, we'd give the magazine away, but I will probably offer it as a subscription. And that was one of the reasons we look to you guys, is for that subscription service. This works well with subscriptions, I hear.
Yeah, it certainly does. Yeah, I think we've got a lot of tools that help you out with a program like that, starting with the fact that we can take a payment, and then after that first one, securely tokenize the card so we can use it later. So what that means, I guess, secure to start. PCI compliance is a big word in our space, and essentially what it means is the consumers running their cards through your system, are you keeping those safe, and do you have the certification to prove that you're keeping that info safe? So all of our gateways are PCI secured. So what that allows us to do is, when Mike jumps online and makes a payment for the first time, signs up for the subscription system, we ask his permission to save the card on file and then go ahead and do so. So 1 month down the line, quarter down the line, however frequently we're resending product, we can, if we want, send a text message, ask Mike if he still wants the next shipment, and then go grab payment from the card on file and keep it moving. So it's a lot smoother. You know, people don't want to have to go into their wallet and type their card number out again if it can be avoided. Any convenience that you can provide like that, it's just less friction for sales, which is what we're all looking for.
Well, it's funny, you know, that you guys have been advertising with us, and we're looking forward to using this system on our own orders. If you keep marketing with me, Mike, you'll be using your own system to pay for your ad with the Texas Hemp Reporter.
Which is hilarious. I actually did not think of that at all. Yeah. But you know what? We're happy to do it.
Yeah, if you guys keep marketing with me here in a month as I get onboarded, I'll send you your link for your payment, and it'll be in your own system that you'll be paying a bill. Has that happened yet with any client?
What? I guess the Texas Hemp Coalition advertising that we've done too. I just don't think Alyssa and I made that connection. But yeah, I actually think that's very funny.
Yeah, that is. Well, listen, thank you for being on here. Fire off the website, fire off an email. How can folks learn more about Flex Payment Solutions and why they should try you guys out for their services?
Yeah, anyone can check us out. Russ mentioned earlier, flexpaymentsolutions.com, all the words spelled out in full. We've got a contact form on there, just an info kind of deal if you want to apply. If you've got questions about processing, we're certainly happy to be a resource, whether you're going to end up being an immediate customer or not. And maybe shouldn't, but I'll be totally open. That contact form goes to me. So if you have any contacts, questions specifically for me, feel free to hit that as well. And then we're on LinkedIn too. Like Russell said, a lot of our team is on there. You can find them off of the company page very easily. And any of them are happy to be resources for this stuff as well. Like I mentioned earlier, we've got a very knowledgeable group.
Yeah, very knowledgeable. And not only that, just regular guys. Everybody that I spoke with, you know, with you, Dom or Matt, the guys I've been interacting with at these events, just hit it off with you guys. So it's you guys are very likable, approachable. One little quick thing here. I noticed the ad on page 11 in the Texas Hemp Reporter has a QR code. It says scan here to get a free statement analysis. I want to encourage viewers and listeners to hit that QR code. What does the analysis offer, Mike, just real quick?
Good question. It's a really nice resource, and we were actually just working through this for a couple of, as you asked earlier, Texas Hemp Coalition groups earlier today.
Oh, wow.
What we can do is, anyone who's got a current processor and you want to see what a change would look like in your fee schedule, reach out to us through the QR code. I think you fill in a couple of contact fields as well. But the big thing is, we'll take your current processing statement, put you through a quote with the pricing that we do for the space based on whether you're retail, online, products you sell, all that good stuff. And we'll get you a side-by-side comparison. And it makes it much easier to make a decision. You don't need to listen to me jabber. You can decide for yourself. We're happy to help with that.
Well, very, very cool. We are looking forward to trying this service out ourselves over here at the Texas Hemp Reporter and the Texas Hemp Show. Mike Biegalski with Flex Payment Solutions, thanks so much for being a part of podcast number 70, buddy. We appreciate you. But
Thank you. I appreciate being here, and stay safe, everybody.
All right. Thank you very much, Mike. Appreciate it. Take care, man. All right. There he goes. That's Mike with Flex Payment Solutions. I'm Russell from the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine, and this is the Texas Hemp Show. We'll be back on the other side of this break. I want to make a good
run. I wanted to go to the moon. Medical marijuana is legal in Texas. Do you suffer from cancer, PTSD, IBS, peripheral neuropathy, autism, epilepsy, seizure disorders, osteoarthritis, or fibromyalgia? Well, medical marijuana is now legal in Texas as of September of 2021. Visit TexasMedicalMarijuanaDoctors.com. Call 713-659-HEMP. That's 713-659-HEMP. And tell them you heard from the Texas Hemp Show. Visit our friends online at TexasMedicalMarijuanaDoctors.com.
Hey, this is Cheech Marin, and you're listening to the Texas Hemp Show.
Why take a chance with your hemp grow? Join Hemp Plan and avoid the risk. TPS Labs' exclusive hemp monitoring program. Hemp Plan members get one-on-one consulting from knowledgeable consultants who are available when you need them most. If you want to take the guesswork out of growing hemp and focus on what matters most, call TPS Lab today and ask for your free consultation. Take the next step to a successful harvest. Visit tpslab.com or call today at 956-383-0739.
You're listening to the Texas Hemp Show, sponsored by The Loot. The Loot, helping vape and smoke shops deliver the most innovative products to customers. Constantly creating new products that people love. E-liquid, salts, CBD topicals, tincture flower, edibles, and Delta 8. Your customers will be shouting, "Give me The Loot!" The Loot, creating high-margin products for vape and smoke shop. Contact us today at thelootjuice.com for all your vape, CBD, and Delta 8 needs. Mention Texas Hemp Reporter for 10% off. Give me The Loot!
The Texas Hemp Reporter is available free at all CBD and smoke shops in Houston and Austin, Texas. Expanding to Dallas and San Antonio this year. Cannabis is slowly becoming legal in Texas, so be sure to listen to the Texas Hemp Show podcast every week, wherever podcasts are available. The premier hemp and marijuana advocacy publication for Texas. The Texas Hemp Reporter magazine. Mailed to over 2,000 licensed hemp producers in Texas. News, technology, trends, finance, culture, health, all things hemp in the Lone Star State. Now in our third year, with more than 100,000 copies made available free at over 1,000 CBD and smoke shops in Texas. That's the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine and the Texas Hemp Show. Visit online at TexasHempReporter.com and listen wherever podcasts are available. Now, back to the show with your host, Russell Dowden.
All right, welcome back to the Texas Hemp Show podcast. This is podcast number 70. I'm Russell Dowden, the publisher and editor for the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine that's available at CBD and smoke shops all over Austin and Houston, Texas. We are adding in more smoke shops and CBD stores in the San Antonio and Dallas, Texas area this coming April. And yes, that is our first April issue this year that we are going to have. So we are kind of looking at maybe kind of having fun with a 420 friendly cover of the Texas Hemp Reporter. And I'm looking to possibly, maybe there may be another Marley on the cover. We're kind of seeing where things play out with the Austin Reggae Festival, but we're lining up some interviews there. The magazine's already coming together with our staff for the April edition, so that's very exciting. If you want to get involved into the magazine or get an article about your business, reach out to me about some marketing goals. We can get you on our show. We can get you on in the magazine with a display advertisement. We have digital opportunities, and then you can, of course, you know, always market your business here and your business message on the Texas Hemp Show with announcements, as we do go to commercial break about twice an hour there. So if you want to build brand awareness, promote some services, or grow your digital presence, attract new customers, expand into a new market, or build your authority in the industry, give us a call or email me at TexasHempReporter@gmail.com. How soon do you need to get some of those that marketing help? If you're looking within 30 to 60 days or 60 to 90 days, let us know. We'd love to help you out. What's your budget? If you want to work with us, we'd be happy to introduce some opportunities for marketing your businesses to our listeners. We do have plans on expanding into the Texas area with more stations. We had a station that we were with here in Austin on 590 KLBJ. It's one of the big talk stations. We had a show there for about 3 months, maybe 13 weeks. So we did the Texas Hemp Show on KLBJ 590 AM here, where we got a lot of good response. But I'm able to also maneuver and get around into some rural markets. And so one of the things I'm going to be doing this year is expanding to Lubbock and Midland and Brownwood and Edinburgh and McAllen down in the Rio Grande Valley. We're looking at a station in Temple with KTEM in News Radio 14. There's a station up near Brady and Brownwood that we're looking at to work with as well at News Talk 102.3. So we're expanding some ideas here with the Texas Hemp Show and getting these out to Lubbock, Midland, Temple, Brownwood, McAllen. This puts us our coverage map of our shows on terrestrial radio throughout the state and near our farmers and our friends that are out there growing hemp. And so I think that'll be a good coverage map for us as we also begin to expand the distribution of the magazine to Dallas and San Antonio here later this spring. But currently you can find the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine in over 300 CBD and smoke shop stores in the Austin, Texas area. We are in over 200 stores and CBD smoke shops in the Houston area. So good. By the summertime, we think we'll be expanded to those other 500 that are in Dallas has 300 more, another 250 or so in San Antonio. So we really feel that we'll be in those 1,000 smoke shops and CBD stores throughout the state here by the early summer. So a special thanks to my guest, Mike Biegalski of the Flex Payment Solutions there joining us on the program this week. I wanted to get Jesse Williams to call me in here. I've asked him to reach out. I'm doing the show this week from home, but wanted to congratulate Jesse and the Texas Cannabis Collective. They came in runners-up as part of the Texas Hemp Awards, and then I believe they won an award as well. And I can't recall if Jess – that's why I was going to have Jesse call me and say – what all that was, but they were nominated like 3 or 4 times in different categories. I believe Jesse came in runner up on Advocate Warrior, and then the collective came in first placed on 1 or 2 items. So they really placed well. And congratulations to all of the winners. We were nominated, but my co-host won for podcast on his, so how damn him. Jesse has started a podcast since we've been doing this one. We're on podcast 70, and his he got more votes for his podcast than mine. Let's get some more votes, guys. It's Russell here with the Texas Hemp Reporter and the Texas Hemp Show magazine. So let's just go ahead and end this thing, and I will have to get Jesse to tell us about this next week and tell us about what it was like winning those awards. I understand there's rings that they got, and they do this every year during Super Bowl. So as Super Bowls comes to end, the announcement of Super Bowl is it ends on Super Bowl Sunday, those announcements are made, and everybody gets their Texas Hemp Award ring. It's like a big, giant, fat Super Bowl ring. But congratulations to all of you who won. I don't have that in front of me, but I know Jesse did. Damn him. And congratulations, though, to everybody there. Stay tuned next week on the show. Let me just tell everybody who I had on for podcast number 71. That is going to be our friends over at Dr. Altamirano will be on from San Antonio of Good Earth MJ. Good Earth is one of our sponsors that has, you can go to his doctor's office and get your script for your legal cannabis and legal marijuana here in Texas. He's one of the few that have graced the pages of the Texas Hemp Reporter magazine in the last 6 months. And so his appearance, Dr. Altamirano, will be on next week on podcast number 71 from San Antonio. That he is with Good Earth MJ. If you are looking for cannabis and need to get these prescription for that, check out Good Earth MJ for that. And then you'll, of course, go to those dispensaries near you and get your medicine filled that way. I'm Russell. Jesse is not here, so I will say adios on his behalf. But thanks for tuning in, guys. We'll see you next week on podcast number 71. Thanks again. And check out our friends at Flex Payment Solutions.